Let's now explore the viscount part of the castle of Ségur. Its most massive feature is its 13th century master tower. This dungeon, a symbol of the viscount's power, preserved its thick outer wall, which is slightly diverted, stem-shaped, and has abutments. Its second floor boasts two lovely mullioned windows, which used to bear small columns and an entrance door. Around 1450, Jean de L'Aigle had the building extended on the west side at the tip of the dungeon. Its construction in the 15th century required enlarging the spur obtained thanks to major leveling works. The masonry of the large barrel vault cellars is intact, and daylight slits bring light into the cellars. An underground ramp led to the cellar from the castle's outdoor courtyard. Another entrance led to the outdoor terrace via a door with a sandstone doorframe decorated with mouldings. On the ground floor, the abode is divided into three large barrel vault rooms. Their casement windows offer a lovely view of the landscape down below the spur. The lintel above the entrance door of the castle site may come from the abode's mantlepiece. Notre-Dame Chapel was built about the same time. Its semicircular chevet is integrated into the east side of the building. The vestiges of this Gothic chapel enable us to imagine how refined this small edifice was. An extremely smooth type of limestone was used to confect the window frames, the arch ribs, and their sculpted bases. The chapel is completed by a small annex, St. Catherine's Chapel, equipped with a fireplace for the comfort of its lords.